Hey everybody, welcome back to Tired Old Queen at the Movies. Before we go see Steve this week, we just want to wish everybody a healthy, happy, and prosperous new year. Now let's go see our favorite tired old queen, Steve Hayes.
Oh, Johnny! Where you been? Come on.
Oh my God. Tired Old Queen at the Movies.
Happy New Year!
I wanted to find the quintessential New Year's Eve movie, and I think I did it. In the grand tradition of Cecil B. DeMille's The Greatest Show on Earth, and Reap the Wild Wind, and Titanic, I got the one disaster movie that was done on New Year's Eve. Irwin Allen's production of Ronald Neame's The Poseidon Adventure, starring Gene Hackman, Shelly Winters, Ernest Borgnine, Stella Stevens, Jack Albertson, Roddy McDowell, and everyone in the world. Now, this movie was based on a novel by Paul Gallico. Paul Gallico was a very famous novelist, popular novelist in the 40s and the 50s. And this movie concerns an ocean liner, which is on a New Year's Eve cruise.
Happy New Year!
The movie has all the stereotypical characters. Shelley Winters and Jack Albertson are the nice Jewish couple heading to Israel to see their grandson.
When we finally get to Israel, we're going to stay put, no traveling. We're going to get to know our grandson. Just think.
Red Buttons is the little businessman who never got married, who's really into organic foods, you know, and all he eats is vitamins all the time, and he needs a woman, so according to Shelley Winters.
Good morning, Mr. and Mrs. Rosen.
Good morning. Don't fall over.
Estella Stevens is an ex-prostitute who married a cop, played by Ernest Borgnine.
Well, I'll tell you one thing it means. It means all your worries about those other women looking down on you is a lot of bull.
Gene Hackman, who just won the Oscar for The French Connection, plays a priest who's sort of radical in his views about things.
Freedom to dump all the rules and all the trappings. And freedom to discover God in my own way.
Leslie Nielsen, who is gorgeous in this movie, is the captain of the ship. And he keeps telling this guy who's the head of the company that owns the ship that they have way too much weight. And if something goes wrong, this ship could capsize. Well, at exactly midnight on New Year's Eve, this ship is struck by a 90-foot tidal wave.
Oh my God.
I cannot tell you the impact that this movie had. This was pre-Jaws, and this movie kind of harkened back to the old spectacles that I was used to watching on Saturday night at the movies when I was a kid. I saw this preview, and they said, on New Year's Eve, the SS Poseidon was capsized by a 90-foot tidal wave. I was in high school. I stood up and screamed like a girl. I was really, really excited. So this movie fulfilled all my dreams. This sequence is one of the most famous sequences ever shot. They had an entire set built at 20th Century Fox that tipped over upside down. And the actors actually had to roll with this whole thing. And you watch pianos crash. It is unbelievable. The whole set was on rollers and went upside down and settles into the water.
Jesus Christ, what happened?
We've turned over.
Gene Hackman figures out that in order for them to survive this, they have to get to the propeller, the place where the ship is the thinnest, and that's the only way they're going to get out. So essentially, they have to climb up to the bottom. They prop up the Christmas tree, the gigantic Christmas tree from the ballroom, which is where they all were when the ship got hit by the tidal wave, and they push it up, and a handful of them climb laboriously up this Christmas tree. And they start this adventure. And the whole premise of the movie is, who's going to make it?
But it's something to try. It's a chance. We might make it. If you stay here, you'll certainly die.
We are staying with the purser.
It is so exciting. Shelley Winters got an Academy Award nomination. She's never been more Shelley Winters in her life. This was at the stage of her life where, you know, she used to be on talk shows and they'd go, well, Shelley, tell us about the Poseidon Adventure. And she'd go, well, Poseidon Adventure, Gene Hackman was one room with Marilyn Brand. One time Marilyn and I with my Oscar as a patch of blue.
The dinner theaters, I lost 18 pounds before I got here and I put on 5 pounds since I've been here.
You never gonna understand things she said. But she's really good in this movie. She was a method actress. she started out in pictures, and then she, in the middle of her, right after Place in the Sun, she went back to New York and did theater. And she really, really was good. Shelley created a type for herself. And there hasn't been any, really been anyone else like her.
I want you to give this to our little grandson.
Why? I'm going somewhere you're not going?
And this movie was a gigantic hit. Everybody went to see this movie. And as a result, Irwin Allen's next movie was one of the first movies that combined two studios and was The Towering Inferno with Paul Newman and Steve McQueen, which we'll do at a later date. But for now, to welcome in the new year, I give you Gene Hackman, Shelley Winters, Ernest Borgnine, Stella Stevens, Roddy McDowell, and a 90-foot tidal wave in Irwin Allen's Poseidon Adventure. Oh my God.
Let's all go to the lobby.
Johnny, Happy New Year. I wanted to bring the New Year's Eve in. Eve. New Year's Eve. Yeah.
Happy New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve. Anyway.
The popcorn can't be beat.